right, Daddy Jack's going to blues. Axel's saying, let's go, let's go. So this recipe here is going to be some smothered pork chops. And a lot of times they use a thinner chops, but these, look at these chops here. These are beautiful. These are T-bone chops. On sale, Lakeisha picked them up, hand-picked them. That's the tenderloin. That's the loin section. These are all beautiful center cuts. I never really seen any so beautiful. They're on sale, closely trimmed, because my idea was to cut some of the fat off. We're going to render it down, and you know, and a little, some cracklings. And but this is a tribute to a friend of mine down in Texas, David Leakes, who I worked with at the Fairmont Hotel when I first started. He was just probably the most fantastic chef, one of the most fantastic chefs I worked with. So, and I was thinking, I said, you know, if we were in England, I would have knighted David Leakes. He'd be Sir David Leakes. Wow. Because that's kind of how high I hold him in self-esteem. So this is a shout out to him and his daughter, Quay. I knew Quay when she was just a little bit. I think Dave's got 7 or 8 children. And his wife, Edna, was a beautiful person, passed away. But Quay is now full grown and has her own baby. So David's, you know, grandfather many times over. So I was talking to him the other day. So I got to do a nice recipe. I remember you showing me this years ago. So there's not a whole lot of fat on these. But, you know, on a thing with smothered pork chops, you want to make sure that, you know, it's super closely trimmed, which these are. I mean, I don't know. I've never seen chops come out of a grocery store this closely trimmed. But we're gonna run it down a little bit anyway. What's that? Huh? Excellent. You hear that? Yummers. So don't be looking at my fingers. So I don't have a lot, but anyway, you gotta put a little flavor. You gotta put some kind of grease to fry them in. So put a little bit of bacon grease. So we're gonna get these going a little bit. These cracklings. I'm gonna cut this one down a little bit. That rendering down. Okay, so get my Daddy Jack seasoning, all purpose. What do they call it? 10-in-1 oil or some kind of oil. It's good for everything. Automotively, this is a good seasoning for anything in the culinary world. Get them going on both sides. Okay. Yes, I got over my surgery and everything, and then Monday, Sunday night, I started feeling not so good and developed that that Lyme disease again. It's about the fifth time I've had it. So had a rough 3 or 4 days, but I'm definitely doing better than I was Tuesday and Wednesday. And thank God for antibiotics. So anyway, we wanna make sure everything's coated really nice with the flour. So we get a nice browning. Some nice whole wheat flour. We're not going to use a lot of flour in this recipe, but the natural, you know, the beauty is the flour that you you flour these in and brown the chops with. That's also going to help thicken the sauce, the gravy. It's not a gravy. I mean, it's not a sauce. It's a gravy. This is all country cooking. So you got a little nice brown going on. It's rendered down some of the fat. But those will be the pieces you want to search out when the dish is done. Trust me. We're also going to add some olive oil because we need a little bit more. We don't want to use any more bacon fat, really. So, I'll push these cracklings off into a corner. And so, when you add these again, always drop it away from you. Okay. Whoa. Actually, you hear that? Oh, that's my favorite sound. One of my favorite sounds. Shouldn't say my favorite. Come on, close. Listen to this. Oh, yeah. All right, so I'm going to move this one over to another burner and kind of just slow brown them, not too hot. And then we're going to save this flour right here for our gravy. But I want you to see this right here. This is some stock I made from some beautiful veal bones that I got at 4 Mile River Farms gave me. Look at this. Look at that. Look at that. Natural jelly, veal bones, beef bones. And, you know, I even use a little bit of this fat. I could have used some of it, but I like to leave the fat in there, covering when I keep in the refrigerator. It like seals the air out, keeps it longer. So, this has got so much flavor, I concentrated it down. So we're going to put that stock for our gravy on the back burner. Turn them so you get all sides. You have different hot spots. Look at that already. Look at that. That's beautiful. That blackened seasoning, the paprika, gives a nice nice color effect. Look at that. I'm gonna slow this down just a hair. Some garlic, you know, plenty of peppers. I love this sauce because it's all capturing the natural flavors. Use any kind of green bell peppers if you want, but we'll be right back. I'm gonna get some of this done, and we'll be right back. We'll cook them on both sides. This one could have used a little bit more, but we'll let that go. And we'll be right back. I want to show you the peppers. You know, sometimes you just slice them all the way down, but I kind of like to do this sometimes. So they make them a little more bite size. Let go. Okay, then, so Come on over, let's take a look. They're getting really nice. See, normally I do, I was gonna veg in a separate pot. You know what, let's do just a one pot dish tonight. And make that cuisinier do all the work. So I'm gonna put some garlic in there now. Let that cook in there. I'm gonna do the onion. Not fine dice, but nice kind of chunks, like a cacciatore. All right, so I'm gonna add extra vegetable in here because, you know, we're gonna have some gravy left over. They make some soup out of leftover or take our peppers. So, you know, I'm not gonna let this get on these. I'm gonna leave that contact. I'm gonna leave the contact down there with the meat so it's still browning, but it's not gonna burn. Like the garlic we added is not gonna burn. And I want to add just a little bit more pepper because it's not, you know, like with blackened seasoning, got a little bit of everything. But sometimes you need just a little bit more, tweak it a little bit. Okay, just a crack or two of some Himalayan salt. What we'll do is we're gonna just put the lid on here before we make our sauce. Just let that go for about 10 or 15 minutes. Give a nice, help it out a little bit before we finish it off and finish it in the oven. Stock in the back, all natural stock there. No, nothing added to it. It's so beautiful. And we'll be right back. Axel, come here, buddy. We hadn't formally said hello. You hadn't said hello today. Come here. You've been doing good. Played in the snow a little bit today. Ran. Take it for a run, but he's going in, what, next week?
Mm-hmm.
A little surgery. But it's just a day surgery. We'll have to leave you overnight. All right, buddy. Love you. Come on, check this out. Woo! Oh yeah, so our chop's probably like maybe half to three quarters. So I'm gonna turn this fire up a little bit. What do you think? You want a little jalapeno in there?
Ooh.
Just a little bit of heat?
Okay.
Huh?
Yep.
I don't know if we have any left. We don't. I mean,
no, there's not one over there. No.
We have one on the plant outside.
Yes.
But now, we don't want to mess with that, right?
I'll go get it.
You want to? All right. Look at those little babies. They're like frozen. there's our guy. You can let him back in. Go check out that pot. Come on. Woo, that temperature dropped. Not frost on the pumpkin this year. There's been snow on the pumpkin. But this is almost so good right here. You know, don't even need to smother it, but we're going to do it. So, you know what? I don't want to dirty that cutting board. Just washed it. We like one or two?
Just one.
Really?
Yeah.
These little jokers might be spicy. You never know. End of the season.
Yeah.
Okay. Watch out. Step back with that. Breathe that jalapeno fumes. Okay, so utilization. Leftover flour. We're gonna use it. You know, it's got a little bit of seasoning in it already. And I always put some in the sink between it, and throw a little water on it. I think we're gonna need another spoonful or two possibly. Because we want to make plenty of gravy. These, like, don't forget these are teaspoons. This one's a teaspoon. Okay? Come on in, look. So we wanna use up most of the absorb most of the fat. Because otherwise you'd have a greasy sauce. Maybe two more. So it's a total of probably 3 tablespoons, 6 teaspoons. But you know, just do it by eye. We do it by eye. Cook that flour a little bit. Nice and hot. Add a little bit at the start. Just like David Leake taught me, work out the lumps. Hope I'm making you proud with this one, brother David. David used to work 2 jobs, 6 in the morning, Republic Bank building, supervising an employee cafeteria and cook from scratch 2,000 meals a day at 2 o'clock. He'd come over to Fairmont. He'd prep up to do 350 dinners at the in the Venetian room, our showroom. We had everybody from Ella Fitzgerald, BB King, so when he'd come over, have a cup of coffee, get himself about a half hour nap in the employee cafeteria at the hotel, and then he'd go to work, set it all up, take it downstairs. Plus he did all the grilling for the pyramid room. It was all one kitchen, which was the 5-star gourmet restaurant. And so he did that. So he'd work like, I think, Monday through Friday at the Republic Bank building. And then he'd work, his only day off was Sundays. Tuesday through Saturday at the Fairmont. On Sundays, he'd take us fishing. We'd go over to his house, have a barbecue. At night he'd take us to clubs, blues club. He took us to this beautiful blues club. Showed me and my assistant banquet chef, Billy McNeil, just a fantastic time. We were the only white guys in the whole place. I said, "Dave, you sure all right here?" He says, "You and me, you're all right." And then he had a boat. He'd take us fishing, and never saw David in a bad mood. Always even keel personality. It is never saw him rattled. His other claim to fame was he'd bet anybody $20 that he'd go on the back parking lot, and they had their car. He'd hold their car back. They couldn't take off. He grabbed their bumper from behind, and kind of lift it up. He was so strong, he lifted up and hold, you know, like the back wheels, so they couldn't take off. I'd never seen anything like it. Just incredible, incredible guy. So anyway, let's test it out. Look at that gravy. Oh my God. The pork flavor mixed with the beef flavor. Woo-wee. Let the good times roll. All right, we're gonna put this in there. Look at that. Look at that. All right. I know Brother Leek's gonna be proud of this one. And then I'd almost sip there right off the plate, but that's gonna add some nice flavor into our dish. And so we're gonna bring it back up to a nice simmer, put the lid on it, have a little bit of some wild rice we're gonna do, a little bit of broccoli, and see, everything was nice and hot already. See how quick it comes back to the boil. So the beauty is having your stock hot, nothing sticks to the bottom. As long as you keep it stirred. All right, check it out. That's smothering. Put the lid on into the Larno, the oven. Well, I'm gonna drop it down to 300, about 20 minutes. Daddy Jack's cooking with the blues. It's cold outside, but it's hot in here. Some chicken stock that I had. Lakeisha roasted a beautiful chicken, one of those smart chickens. But okay, with rice. Okay, we're gonna just cut this slit just the corner right here, so you can wrap it up tight. And then, the rice you want to put in, just like a thumbnail. I don't care what container you're using. Hell, this might take. All right, so we're gonna. I might take this whole bag. Right there, so. And then I got a jalapeno left in there that I left in the stock. But here's what we're gonna do with this, because it's still got plenty of flavor. And cut that. But first, I wanna make sure we don't have too much stock, because then you're gonna have rice that's overcooked. That absorb. Yeah, see, we got a little bit too much stock. See, right there is about what we want. You can stick your ladle in there. Yeah. You have perfect rice every time. We'll just let that go. That should be there in about 10-15 minutes or so. Axel, you smell it? Come on in, look. Watch out, buddy. Kick it up a little bit. You know, just get her going real good. But it's done. That's been going about 5-10 minutes. Plus what we had in there before. We're going to shut the oven right down. Let that carry over heat. Just finish it off. Rice going strong. I took some of those stems. One pot cooking, like I said, and gonna let that steam up. I said we got about another 10 minutes. You hold off that long, Lakeisha?
I don't have a choice.
All right, not really.
No.
All right, be right back. Axie, Wacky Axel. Sit, buddy. It's showtime. Hey, so check it out now. Come on in. Oops. There's some broccoli. I just put the stems up on top. Didn't have room for the florets. But this is it. This is it. This is it right here. This is what it's all about. Don't not overcook, because which one do you think you want, Lakeisha? That one? That one?
Well, we're splitting.
I know.
So we'll go for the big one.
This one here?
Looks like that one.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I've been giving my marching orders. We're splitting. So here we go. And I don't care. I'm going in with one, the big spoon. And we'll put a little jalapeno on there for us. Oh. This is what we're doing here. Gravy time. You know why? Because with smothered gravy, you need plenty of gravy. Trust me. Mm. Soak up some of that with that rice. Mm-hmm. It's so colorful, and we're not even going to mess with the green onions tonight. TD Leeks, Theron, David Leeks. I remember that name for the rest of my life, because I learned more from you about cooking, I think, than anybody in my life. And you know, when I first moved to Dallas with the chef, Klaus Middlehauser, you know, it was a lonely place because I didn't know anybody, a big hotel. I never worked, I mean, I did work in big operations, but new city, and you were what a true friend is all about. Love you, brother. Love your family, Quay, Quay's baby. I know Quay's cooking, so we're going to get her to do a video, and if it wasn't for COVID, David would be up here already, and we would have probably had a bunch of videos in the can. We're going to do that soon. All right, Axel, out of my way, because we're heading to the table. And we're going to take a picture, and we're going to dig in. All right, so before I dig in, you know, it's, you know, I had to bring out the Henkel, my paring knife. We're going to use that, because, you know, David and I had a connection with Klaus Middlehauser, but tomorrow's Halloween. I know this might come out a little bit after Halloween. I just looked out the window. It was a full moon the night before Halloween. So I got a good joke. It goes way back. I think my mother told me the joke. Why couldn't the ghost get the witch pregnant?
Why?
Because he had a Halloweenie. Right. Actually, I guess he didn't want to eat, but So then Lakeisha, you know, really funny, but something even more funny, she asked me, are you going to, you know, we got to shoot you digging in and eating and all that, because I know she's starving to death, because I said, don't worry about it, but of course, that's what it's all about, you know, I'll go quick, 2 bites, that's it. Wow. Quiet over there, Vanessa. But you know what? That was a big thing for me, watching Justin Wilson. He would take his, he'd sit down, have a glass of wine. Ooh-wee. This is where it's at for me, is the rice and gravy. And,
All right. Starving.
Keisha's got some hangry going on.
Yep.
Dad Jack's cooking with Blues. Check us out. With the Blues. Check us out. Daddy Jack's newlondon.com. I have a CD that we just produced from 20 years ago, recorded with Sam Myers. T-shirts, blackened seasonings. Think of us for the holidays if you're looking for a unique gift. T-shirts, hats, other memorabilia coming up. Love you all. Stay safe. Indoors. Cold weather coming. We hope everybody stays safe. Love you all. Yeah, so, you know, Lakeisha was starving. I tell you what, but I had what I wanted, Lakeisha had what she wanted, because, you know, she had 3/4 of that pork chop and she didn't even come up for air. And also, she made a little applesauce in there. Hey, whatever floats your boat, I'm good with that. And Alec, you know, Axel, he's tearing in. I left him, you know, some more rice and gravy on the, you know, he get the rice all over the floor, but he cleans up after himself. But, I just want to say, that was, Lakeisha bought these chops on sale at ShopRite, all closely trimmed, top of the line chops, $2.30 a pound. So, you know, what I'm trying to say is, cooking economically, we shared a chop, and that was enough for both of us. It was 2-inch thick chop. More than enough,
yeah,
right? Because we couldn't stop. It was so good. You know, it's but you know, just home cooking is can't be beat. The flavors, and you know, just put a little bit of effort into it, and you're gonna reap. You know, like everything in life, you're gonna reap the rewards. And so that whole dish with the rice, everything included, was like $15-16 bucks. So that meal we ate just then was $5 or $6 split between the two of them. Now we got gravy. You can make some pot pies with it. You can, you know, there's a multitude of, you know, out of $15, we're probably, you know, 4 or 5 meals down the road. So, you know, you want to economize and save some money. It's quick, you know, like I say, you know, I've said it before, like you wait till 5 o'clock. Hey, what are we going to have for dinner? Go to get something fast food, take out, get something to deliver. You don't feel like leaving the house, especially in the wintertime. Plan ahead, spend a few bucks, cook some home-cooked meals, plan your meals ahead, a few days ahead, 3 days ahead. And, you know, you'll appreciate it down the road, because there's nothing like cooking for yourself. It's healthier, and it's definitely more cost-effective. But enough preaching for me. Love y'all. Take care.
Mm-hmm. I met you, it was in a dream. That you would never, ever, ever be so mean. But yes, darling, you left me with a broken heart. Yes, darling.